I love Sauté Sow. Like anytime, any day, just give me Sauté Sow and I'm fine. And how do we even tell you that it is Tuesday? Susanna, welcome to the Tuesday edition of eSplash. As usual, our tradition is a blend of movies and music, all for your viewing pleasure.
That's right, honeypots. It's always a pleasure to do this. And today we are set to give you a great show this afternoon.
Yes, so it's all about music meeting movies. Welcome on board, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, this is Roy and this is Flanus. I go by the name King OJ, but you can call me OJ. That's where it is.
It is what it is.
And of course, it's your girl, Amanda Dara. And today you can call me whatever you want to call me. You're allowed.
Chimamanda.
I thought you would jump at it.
Any other person apart from OJ? Yeah. I will pardon it. Just for today.
Yeah.
Okay. Chimamanda. Hey. All right now. It's your homegirl, it's your girlfriend next door. It's the jewel in the crown. My name is Honeypot.
Yes, sir. What do we have planned for you guys today? We'll start off with the entertainment news as usual. Mm-hmm. Take today's celebrity birthday shout out and then rewind to this day in entertainment history.
Yes, and of course, King OJ will bring us today's dose of social media craziness on Tweetville. And then later on, we'll chew it off and then take the news recap.
On today's Daily Top 5, we'll take a look at 5 police brutality Hollywood-themed movies. Later on, we'll talk all about movies and TV shows we recently watched or are currently watching, and wrap up the show with Where Are They Now?
Yes, sir. Let's get the show started. We'll be back with today's news stories. Stay with us.
Our brother in the diaspora, has he joined the protest?
He's part of the people that they dragged too. I don't know how far.
That you should talk, like, right?
Jidenna, because before we know it now, you now come to Nigeria and go and be doing
That was a deal.
All right, thank you guys for staying here with us. Now, time for entertainment news. Let's get right into it. Davido gives report on his meeting with the police authority. Following the ongoing #EndSARS and #EndPoliceBrutality protest, Nigerian artist Davido has given reports as regards his meeting with the public relations officer of the Nigeria Police Force, Frank Umba. According to the singer, the special police unit SARS is over and he has been given the directive to oversee the redeployment of the officers. Take a look at the clip.
The ones,
SARS.
You brought justice first.
Yeah. Accountability.
Accountability.
Yeah.
The reform.
Reform.
You need to see it. We're setting up. IG has given me assurance and directive to set up my own panel.
Yeah.
Independent panel that will be overseeing retraining and redeployment of
officers.
SARS is over.
Over.
There should be no reason. Any police, tell you to bring your phone. That is done.
All of this is coming after Davido revealed on social media that he will be having a meeting with the Inspector General of Police over the ongoing protest, a decision that some Nigerians dismissed, stating that the protest doesn't have any leadership.
Obio!
Bares!
Like, so this story is like in 2 parts.
Yes.
The first meeting, the first sit down we had with Mr. Frank Umba, where the video went viral, where he was saying, I know about protest.
I didn't join the protest.
I did not join the protest.
I was just
with my fans, trying to make everything peaceful. But all of this, he has released a statement saying he didn't deny joining the protest. He was just trying to calm the whole situation down.
And the video
was taken out of context. That's the meeting proper happened, and that is where the interview came from.
Okay.
Yeah.
So to continue from where you stopped, I actually watched the full video with the IGP, which was posted on Ubi Franklin's page, I believe, where he actually read out,
he listed out the five things that we want
as youth, and he talked about them. He even shared his own story about how one time he was scared, he had to run to his father's house and all of that. So I think this is a case of Davido trying to sit on the fence. That's the way I see this, because he obviously, with video evidence, was part of the protest in Abuja. According to him, when he got there, they were even insulting him, saying, oh, why are you just coming now? Oh, why? What are you doing here? And according to him, and I'm quoting him as he's telling the IGP, he said he was only staying there to calm them down. However, that's not the way it looked like to us. Mm-hmm. On the other side of things, it looked like you are for us, you are, you know, representing us. So I think Nigerians were hurt, you know, and a little bit embarrassed to see him saying, I'm not joining protest. It's like, do you have, are there two Davidos? Because we clearly saw that you did join this protest. However, again, like I said yesterday, for whatever reason anybody is joining this protest, be it you want to feel responsible, you want to talk for Nigerians, you want to lead it, you want to cloud chase, whatever reason it is, the end goal is beneficial for all of us. Mm-hmm. And I feel like mm-hmm. him going there and taking that move to talk to the IGP, he might not have handled it the best way, but I am happy he did.
Yes, definitely.
Of which I do not even agree with anybody sitting on the fence. You can't be lukewarm. No, you can't. It's either you or here.
So quick one, this committee that they've handed over to Davido to set up, which celebrities do you think it should have in this?
So as they have said,
celebrity or any individual?
I think it should be any individual, because they have said it could be a celebrity, it could be any individual. And I'm saying it again. People are saying, they're repeating it. This is for, if you're doing it, it's for me, it's for you, mm-hmm. it's for, it's, there is no leadership. There is like, there is no leader. Oh, this is our leader, oh, and this is the president of the protest. No, we are all doing it for ourselves at the end of the day, because people are there telling their stories. People have been killed. Mm-hmm. People have been maimed. People's children, people's siblings and all that. And it's just so sad.
You have not given me any name.
My own opinion, I feel like if they're going to set up a panel, just like how we all came out in unison to talk about this, we can unify in a unified manner, vote for people
that we feel on Twitter.
Because the truth of the matter is, it's good that this protest is not for anyone and nobody's spearheading it. But then where is the direction? So some few heads are needed to actually direct it, because now we're very, very emotional, we're very angry as young people, and that could easily just change course. So if they want to actually set up a panel, I feel like it can't just be anybody. It has to be people with experience, people who actually have the best interests of youth at heart, and people who are peaceful about whatever it is that they're trying to.
And the reason I say it could be anybody, not anybody not having anything in the head. I'm just saying that it could be somebody that is not well known to people.
Yes, yes.
But that person has something to offer at the end of the day.
Yes, I completely agree with you.
Where to go?
Set up a panel.
Anybody. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen.
But why you can't say your fans? Wow.
Yes, he said it was, that video was taken out of context.
Okay.
So just
I was just seeing different things on Twitter yesterday. Just some I was retweeting, and I saw a particular one that somebody was saying that Davido's song is like number one in Nigeria right now, Femme, but I'm sure he's not saying Femme to the leaders. I'm like, okay, don't leave us, John.
Checking out the next story, ladies and gentlemen. Funke Akindele and husband granted state pardon. Yes, Nigerian movie maker Funke Akindele Bello and her husband JJ Skills have been granted state pardon by the Lagos State Governor Babajide Sanwo-Olu, who also approved the release of 56 inmates from various correctional centers. According to the statement signed by the State Attorney General and Commissioner for Justice Muyosore Onigbanjo, SAN, stated that the couple, who are both non-custodial convicts, were granted state pardon for disobedience of the COVID-19 lockdown regulation. If you would recall, Funke and her husband, JJC, were arrested following Twitter backlash for organizing a birthday party in their residence despite the restriction of movement order and social distance order in the state. They were, however, arraigned before a chief magistrate court in Ogba and sentenced to 14 days of community service with a fine of 100,000 naira each for violating the lockdown directive. So they are good now.
I thought they were good a long time ago.
Yeah,
two weeks passed.
Yeah, they needed to let
us
know that.
They need to get it officially.
I
mean, we're happy for them. Maybe this is part of the reasons why Naira Marley, you know, came out and you know, went back to wherever he came from. But talking about Akindele and her husband, we're happy that now they can be pardoned by the state and come out and speak for all of us.
It's okay. You know, they apologized and they did what they were supposed to do and they were really sober. So, I mean, if they're back pardoned, it's no big deal.
They committed the crime, they did the time.
It's fine.
And I know that people won't do that again when you
hear
that.
Honestly speaking, this generation, you have to be careful. Twitter will come for you.
Twitter just pushed that.
I'm looking forward to our next election, actually, just to see how things are going to be. Twitter, what do you say you're going to do again?
So, I am hoping... praying that we're not going to be carried away so soon. And, you know, we'll do the needful.
I hope so, too.
I really hope so.
All right, moving on to more news. Lil Frush breaks silence on domestic violence accusation. Nigerian rapper Lil Frush, who was formerly signed to Davido's record label DMW, has broken his silence following the domestic violence allegation leveled against him by his girlfriend Gift Camille with the social media handle Cute Gemini. Lil Frush took to his Instagram page where he had deleted all his previous posts, leaving just a post which had his statement. He wrote, and I'm quoting, "Based on the wide range of incidents between I, Sani Goriola Wasiu, Lil Frush, and Ioma Tariri, Oke Ogene Taiwo, the Cute Gemini, I would like to inform my fans and loved ones that we are on top of the situation. We urge friends and fans of I, Lil Frush, to be at ease and to entertain fear or cause further rancor to this situation. We also like to state that we condemn violence in all forms, be it domestic or otherwise. I sincerely apologize for my actions and inactions. Thank you." If you recall, Lil Frush was called out on Instagram by Mayox_Michael, who happens to be the brother and manager of the victim, Gift Camille.
Why do I feel some attitude in the whole thing you read? Because if you're going to apologize, I think that should have come first.
I don't even think it was an apology. Because, yes, he said, "I apologize for my inactions." What were your actions? And what were your inactions?
And that you're on top of it, that you're married, and then you don't want to do it.
Somebody asked a very critical question. Please, which fans are you addressing? Because this nowadays...
No, let us even say that they are fans, because everybody can have... You can have a fan. That's not even my own business. I am just asking here that... Are you married to that person? Which game are you on top? Then you're now saying that at the end, you're not coming with... No! I'm just saying because you have to be... You know?
So here's the thing. He was...
I don't get it.
On a more serious note, I mean, he was leveled a very heavy accusation of domestic violence, which came with picture evidence. Now, when you're trying to reply or, you know, respond to something like that, it's such a heavy accusation. You cannot say, "I apologize for my actions." What were your actions?
Who wrote that for him?
Like, it's very vague. It doesn't say anything. We want to know who hits this young lady right here. If it's not you, come out and say it's not you. If it's you, say it is you and apologize with your full chest. Don't come and tell us that we should be at ease.
They're on top of it.
Are you on top of? What are you on top of?
Nothing is not mine.
What are you on top of?
My business is that you don't beat a woman, and a woman too. Don't beat a man. Like, don't be violent. That's just my nonsense.
Use your mouth and say, "I did not do it" or "I did it." Don't say that your inactions and your actions.
On top of what? Who are they talking to?
They're on top of it.
All right, that's all we can before some people get on my nerves right now.
They're on top of it.
That's all we can take on the entertainment news. Let's get right into celebrity birthday show. In alphabetical order, today's celebrants are the following people. Ashanti is 40 today. She is an American singer, songwriter, record producer, model, and actress. She was first discovered as a teenager and later signed to Murder, Inc. in 2002. That year, she was featured on Fat Joe's What's Love and Ja Rule's Always in Time. Always in Time. Both of which became two of the biggest hit songs of 2002.
Ashanti.
I think sometime last year, she came out to do a screening, like a birthday party or something, and she was singing, and then speaker stopped working, and she just
continued.
We're like, Ashanti still got it. She still has it. Oh my gosh, love Ashanti.
Oh, I love Ashanti. And the relationship between Ashanti and Nelly, they actually met in 2003 at a conference for Grammy, and then they started dating the next year, and the relationship went 10 years, and they broke up after 10 years in 2014.
Regionalist.
Okay. Yeah. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. I didn't know that.
I was thinking that you were enjoying the...
I was enjoying it. You can't even say it started 10 years later. Not ended. This is how it started.
Because these are public figures and we keep tabs on all of these things.
We know. We agree.
It's just our job. Now, don't call me Beboro. Okay, moving on, guys. Sasha Baron Cohen is 49. is an English comedian, actor, writer, and producer who's known for his creation and portrayal of fictional satirical characters in movies such as Borat, Tyler, The Dark Knight, The Ballad of Ricky Bobby, Bruno, and Admiral General Aladdin in Dictator.
Dictator is a very stupid movie.
If you have watched that, if you have not watched that movie, it's not like the name at all. It's absolutely stupid.
General Aladdin.
And the funniest thing about him is that he has a serious face. He has the kind of face that you look at as a dictator, and then he's like, "What is this person doing?"
He can play different characters, switching it, voicing. Facial expression, one moment is the dictator.
Yes.
And it's making you laugh. And if you laugh, kill
him. Because
kill
he actually...
Kill him.
He actually started with the theatrical stuff. So you know that this is like an actor.
Happy birthday.
Tisha Campbell is 52 today. She is an American actress, comedian, singer, and dancer who has acted in several Hollywood movies and series. On television, she is popular for starring as Gina in the Fox comedy series Martin from 1992 to 1997, and as Janet in the ABC comedy series My Wife and Kids from 2001 to 2005, for which she received the NAACP Image Award for Outstanding Actress in a Comedy Series.
Gina in Martin with Martin Lawrence.
Yeah.
Crazy.
My wife and kids. I love her from that one as well. She's a very great actress.
That's right. All right, coming to Nigeria, Yomi Black is 38 today. Is an Nigerian actor and filmmaker whose comedy skit series Sunday and Lolade made its theatrical debut as the first Nigerian comedy skit series to premiere at the cinemas. He started out as a radio presenter, after which he branched out into producing movies, comedy skits, documentary, advertising shows, and photography. And by 2009, he had earned a reputation as a celebrity photographer.
His Instagram page right now is filled with a whole lot of comedy things.
That's the thing about Yomi Black. Like, he's so talented.
And he's so blunt, too.
You know him for different things.
Yeah.
You know, some people know him for his skits. Mm-hmm. Some people know him for his documentaries. Some people know him for his photography.
He's blogging to his Instagram page.
Times. You know, and being blunt.
Just know him as Yomi Black, Sha. Yomi Black. Happy birthday to him. Super multi-talented.
Yes, happy birthday to him. Happy birthday to everybody celebrating today. We love you. I'm not going to go, we love you.
We love you, man.
We actually do love you. We know that the times we're in, but still take out some time, again, to pray for yourself and for your family, and of course, for Nigeria.
That's right.
All right, that's all we can
After you pray, you will not even kiss.
Okay, happy birthday. Mwah. Time for today's history lesson. Take a look at Rewind.
Let's rewind. On this day in 1973, Badlands, directed by Terrence Malick and starring Martin Sheen and CeCe Spacek, premieres at the New York Film Festival. And in 1978, The 52nd Street, a sixth studio album by Billy Joel, is released. It went on to win the Grammy Award Album of the Year in 1979. Finally, on this day in 2016, American singer-songwriter Bob Dylan is awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature. And that's it on Rewind.
Yes, sir. Adekunle Gold right there. Nila, Black Man, AG, baby. Adekunle Gold giving us.
You said Adekunle Gold there. He's in Nigeria. He's Houston now.
Yes, yeah, protesting there now.
Because he said Adekunle Gold there.
Adekunle Gold, Nila, Black Man.
Okay. He was just talking about the song Gold.
Adekunle Gold right there.
Just that his name.
Is this a drag?
They are dragging. Not you, Bill.
Anifa will drag you.
Let's just move to 2D, though.
Can I tell her to off the mic again?
You cannot tell her to off the mic.
Don't even say honorable. Off the mic. I will bite you.
It's time for Twitch below. Time to find out today's latest in social media, humor, and savagery.
Maybe
We are very careful.
So somebody put up this post, and this is a Boniki Bam, and it says, white people, try this African lip balm.
Y'all are so wicked.
Wait, it's not done. It's not done yet. It's not done yet.
Okay.
Next. And Oluchukwuna replied, why are you lying to them? Guys, do not listen to her. This is eye cream. Get rid of dark circles in no time. So who is wicked now? Is it the lip balm one or this Oluchukwu that said?
Oluchukwu is wrong. In fact, Oluchukwu, you are racist. It has even
eye balm. At least the lips one is still better.
What?
But eye. Aboniki, telling white people.
One, see, if, that's one day if, I was feeling brave. I put it in Simon.
Nose!
What was it?
I was just praying, God, if you take me out of this situation,
I will never do it again.
What?
White people, please don't eye bomb. You just die.
Come on, small pepper. They say, she's hot, it's chilly. Have a bye. This one, they'll go to hospital.
Yeah.
Because.
Guys, don't try
this. Oh, please.
Yeah.
Even if you're not white, it's not for the faint hearted. Okay.
Also, so at US_BS. UK puts up this post, American versus British. Mm. In US, it's called cookie. In UK, it's called biscuits. Wait for it. Mm-hmm. Wait for it. Oladayo said, in Nigeria, cookies, if it's expensive.
That's true.
Biscuits. It's not biscuit. Biscuits. If it's cheap.
That's very right. That is 100% correct.
Because
when you see cookies self, you see the packaging, you know what I'm saying?
There are some cheap chocolate droppings.
No, I don't know.
But the thing is that this Nigerian station is a very funny one.
When you're going to the Malam, you don't say, give me cookies. You say,
but they have it.
Do you have biscuits? Yeah. That's why it's different.
Let me help you break it down. Mm. So you know that they say Julius Berger. Mm. If you're going to Berger, you stand on the road and be calling Berger. You will sleep there. You hear me? Get to the market and be saying, curry. See, me, I know when to switch. Mm. When I switch like this, you're not going to even know whether I can speak.
Even hear the name cookies. What are we saying?
I'm just sorry for you.
Expensive. Mm. I'm a cookies kind of girl. You know, I don't do biscuits.
They're expensive biscuits, you know, right? Yeah.
It's true, Sha.
Okay,
it's true.
Amanda.
But I do cookies.
I will come here and drag you. The next time I'm eating something, you're saying that. What are you eating? Honeypot?
I won't even lie to all of you. All these ones I say. You see that biscuits they sell in traffic? It hits you differently. Forget.
Pretty Bert puts up this post and he's saying, everything is funnier when you're not even allowed to laugh.
Yo, this is so true. It's so true.
Wow.
especially when two people are arguing or they are fighting and it's just very funny and you cannot laugh. That's when you want to laugh. What are you saying? Who are you so sad? That's when that thing is to happen.
Let's just move on.
If you have a best friend too, it's always bad. You and your best friend causing trouble.
Yeah. Anambra Virgin put up this post. How lazy are you? And somebody replied, I'll rather use it like this than reassemble. So this is the carton of whatever electronics or whatever this person bought. And the person just puts whatever on it. Like, no stress me. Why should I bring out what is inside and start reassembling it?
That is actually a drawer. Because I'm seeing the picture, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. So that's where he's supposed to be putting his lamp stamp. So he's so lazy because you are there and I want to put something on top of you, so I can't remove the... This is bad. This is not a Nigerian youth. We don't do this. We're not lazy.
Okay.
Are we lazy?
Nah.
Even Nigerian youth can be even stingy to themselves. You see, they'll say this wristwatch is 700K. Say, wait, so with this wristwatch...
Take
itself off my wrist, get into my wardrobe. When I want to go out, it comes on my wrist.
That is not being lazy. That's being prudent. That is being conscious, socially aware, which we are as Nigerians. But one thing we are not is we're not lazy.
Yes.
We're not lazy.
Tell that to the president. That's not it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. You said what you said, right?
What did I say?
I heard you.
@_SamMin put up this post. It says, I'm in the library and there's a boyfriend helping his girlfriend study. And I've been overhearing parts of their conversation for the last hour. And he just said, babe, I'm going to be honest with you. You're going to fail this test. I love you, but there's nothing we can do about it now. I'm dead.
I love this kind of relationship. Yes. I love
that
it.
That is, you just tell yourself the truth, babe.
You ladies will like this one. If your guy just went plain, like, you see?
No, the thing is that at that point, you might not like it, but even eventually, I think you'll like that truth.
It's the tonation at which you said it. Like, babe, I'm going to be honest with you. You're going to fail this.
You're going to fail.
That one is more annoying.
But no, that one is okay. That one, you love me. You're joking.
That is so annoying.
It's sweet.
They didn't even know what they want. Look at them.
Oja, are you crazy?
Look at them.
I just thought to ask.
They didn't even know what they want. Let's move on. So Atiun's death put up this post. He said, brush and use deodorant. Oh, don't go and cause another protest in the protest. Hashtag SAST must end.
Louder. Some things are going on inside this protest.
Some
people are fighting for food.
You know what? Because even during COVID, I had to post it because everybody was staying at home. And you now see bath. Somebody, they're not. I said, I said, take your bath, clip your nails, do this. I did not even put full stop. I now said,
brush.
Comma, don't be silly. Somebody laughs at me.
Brush and use it. It's very
kilo. They don't kill us.
So are we losing the end goal? The end goal is to protest SARS and SARS. So why are you concerned? Why are you concerned about freshness?
So now you want to kill
that's
us.
That's part of the things we are protesting.
So you don't want to
that
kill us.
It's not a crime to be fresh. Okay, eh? It's not a crime, Nigerian youth. It's not a crime. Be fresh. Give us drip.
It's not a
Give
crime to have dreads. So.
Protest drip. We're here for it.
So we're supposed to turn up. We're supposed to turn up. Yo. And sir.
I hope you understand that one.
Let's just move on. Mm-hmm. Huh. So there's a picture of a little girl taking pictures, and the caption is, "We all have that friend who goes extra when taking pictures and still end up taking
no
rubbish."
Sense.
Name is Kemi. I will drag her. Her name is Kemi. She's my friend.
So she will do all the bending
down. Kemi use glasses. She will not now use her glasses. When we're going for events, she will not wear her glasses because she feels like she wants to be a babe.
Yeah.
She will not say, girl!
Yeah.
Oh my God! Fire! You can't say I just say blurry. Kemi.
No, let me tell you the one that even pained me the most. So I had interviewed this particular governor, former governor of Osun State. I went all the way. So for this person, after the interview, I now said, take me this picture. I did not know, the person did not even show me. So maybe the person was starstruck and, you know, the hands were shaking. I'd gotten to Lagos. Me that I wanted to go and put on social media. This is part of the things I have done in my life. I could not cry that day.
Wait, so you don't have any clear
you
picture?
You should have posted it like that.
No,
they would blurry, but we move. We move. If it was, what are you talking about? If it was Obama, we would not put it.
And one guy that traveled for the first time to the UK and took pictures, and he just got back to Nigeria, and his phone, you know how your phone gets paused, and then it does not work again. He cannot recover it. And all the pictures. It's just one picture.
If you not take picture, you are not
that his friend took off his social media one day. He took off his WhatsApp status or something one day. So that one just posted to him. That's the only picture after going to everywhere. CNN, Kiniko.
You don't go.
You don't go anywhere.
Sorry.
So I put up this post and the caption is, watching the final episode of an interesting or long series has to be one of the most depressing things there is. Game of Thrones fans, get in here.
I'm on this table.
Like, you'll be
I'm
depressed. Like,
so what am I supposed Apple to do with my life? Now? What is it? What do I live for? What do I really stand for? Because, in fact, you know that some of these things said, Big Brother, it's as not, it ended, some people did not know what to do with their life again. If you know,
that's
you know.
When, that's why you'll not be hearing, but that person should have not died. That person should have not died now.
I am on that table. I miss Big Brother.
Me, I used to go. For,
no, don't do your eyes like that. I'm telling you the truth now.
Okay.
So, moving on to North Wing. Nothing.
Yeah, so, everybody's virtually on this table.
Wow,
So why did you pretend?
No, I'm on this table. You're on this table. She's on this table.
Why were you now looking at me in a funny way?
Nothing. You want to drag me?
Don't drag me, OJ.
No.
OJ, want yourself. Don't drag me. I will scatter it and drag you like
Ladies and gentlemen, that's it on today's Tweetville.
Thank you so much.
And of course, the first hour of the show. We'll see you at one for lots and lots of movie talk. So stick around.
No,
I'm sorry.
Okay, guys, welcome back to the second half of the show. It is now time to chew it off. Time for us to vent about what's bothering us. Take your
Okay, what do I want to talk about
what
today? I want to talk about, like, because this one just happened yesterday night, I believe before yesterday night. People
happened?
That run the red lights.
Okay.
Yes, I guess we all do it once in a while, but I think it's risky. It's more risky when you do it in the night.
Mm-hmm.
And not you being a saloon car or anything, you are a truck.
Hmm. What?
Yes, a truck did that yesterday night, and the car on the other side just sped off. The guy actually hit his brake, and the guy actually froze there. The car that this thing happened to, the guy froze. People had to come down from their car and say, "Oga, you can move now," because the way he slammed his brake, and the truck was just going after beating the traffic lights.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
This guy in his car, after slamming the brake, he just froze. You know when you just know that
you just
missed death. Like, the guy was just in his car, like, people now had to go to the car and say, "Oga, sorry, oh yeah, move." So, yeah, we all do.
I don't.
Yeah. But I think
no,
it's,
I don't.
Yeah, I think it's
I am
crazy.
Very conscious, because I know that it's risky and
yes,
can die.
Yes, because cars can, like, we should, it's not cool, man.
It's not cool. It's not even the right way to drive.
Yeah,
it's not.
Even you being a truck and doing this in the night.
That truck matter, eh? Mm. That one is another thing. Night. Like, it's another rant. No, it's not about traffic lights, oh. Hey, those ones, they're like, they have one spirit in
like,
them.
They don't care about they other cars.
Wait! You know when you're going to, you know 7-Up?
Yeah.
You know when you pass the, you know, where the police are always, and then you're just going, you know that small bend.
Yeah, okay.
I said, I was the first person to get there, and this truck was coming. You know those ones like snake? I said that day, I was shaking like that. I said, this is the end.
No, you're
it don't end. Like,
you're supposed to stop.
I thought it was going to crush my car and then, like, you don't, like, I was not kunkulu like this. And the thing now came like, I was shaking. They do it on purpose. Like, and now, about traffic lights. Especially at night.
Yes.
Especially at night. I am always very careful. Because if you now say you're now going to just go and not obey the traffic, and something happens and somebody is just coming and speeding, you're just going to kill yourself. And I think that, you know, not everybody in Nigeria knows how to drive. And I'm saying this because there is even this place, this Awolowo, when you're going to, like, you're facing Otedola, you're coming under the bridge, like when you're coming from the mall. So there was a day, it was my turn to go. And then I was already going. This person was coming from, like, the mall side. And the person was going to, you know, where I'm talking about, the PHN,
the person was going to.
And the person went to turn, like when you're supposed to turn and go, like, you know that you can't take the whole road because other people are coming straight down. In fact, that road is my road at that point. And then you just went and left all the space and went to turn like this. What if I was speeding?
We don't know the right of way.
We don't know. As you said, a lot of Nigerians have not been taught how to drive properly. We drive aggressive driving. And it's also because we feel like we own the road and somebody is going to drag it with us. So
the
we have
drivers.
To. Yeah, the truck drivers feel like, oh, we're driving this big car.
So you should be careful.
Even on the way to work today. You know, they're fixing the road on the way to work. Yeah, beep, 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 beep. I'm like, is it until someone loses control of the steering wheel that you'll be happy? Where are you rushing to? Most times they're not rushing anywhere. So it's a problem. Another reason why people break red lights is because they see other people doing it. And it looks fun.
Hmm.
Don't bother with them.
Hey,
about them.
Hey. You know, this when thing you red, talked about, I still discussed with my sister. And my sister's friend said they even disappear. The truck drivers, like, that is why you don't see them. Like, you just see, like, their boy. So they use juju, like after killing people, they just disappear.
After this one,
it's the first time I heard it.
After this guy did this, yes, it's not your right of way, it's the other car. The guy sped
off. Now, it's not.
No, I'm not talking about disappearing, like running away. They said they will leave their truck there and use juju and.
It's crazy. Just be careful. Be very careful.
We're going to be all right.
Oh, gosh.
We're going to be all right.
All right, moving on from that very, very, very necessary rant. Please be driving safe in Lagos and wherever you are in Nigeria. Please. It is now time for a quick recap of the entertainment news.
Davido gives report on his meeting with the police authority.
We also talked about this one, Funke Akindele and husband granted state pardon.
Yes, we also told you that Lil Frush breaks silence on domestic violence accusation. All right, guys, that's all we can take on the entertainment news recap. Daily Top 5 is up next. See you soon.
Yes, sir. Welcome back to the show. And we move. As the masses awaken to the issues of police brutality in Nigeria, with the hashtag #EndSARS protest happening all over the country, the long-endured oppression of those appointed to protect the citizen have given birth to movie recreation of real-life situation. Today, we'll be talking about five Hollywood police brutality-themed movies that tells the story and lends a voice to the cause. This is Daily Top 5.
5, 4. 3, 2, 1, go!
Number 1, The Hate U Give. The 2018 movie is based on the novel of the same name by Angie Thomas. The movie is about a white cop who shoots down a black young man who he feared was about to pull out a gun, but was indeed wielding a hairbrush. To many, the movie is one of the more realistic depictions of police brutality in the U.S. Cast includes Amanda Stenberg, Regina Hall, Russell Ahnds, Lama Johnson, and Issa Rae. Check this out.
Today, Garden Heights is reeling after the shooting of a 17-year-old black teenager by a white police officer.
We live in a complicated world.
It doesn't seem that complicated to me.
Mm. Oh, no. Mom, what a complicated world indeed.
Yes, I mean.
My guy just wanted to,
they still
did,
looks.
Yeah, they did everything. You know, as a black, mm-hmm. when the police
put your
stop
hands
you,
on
just
the dashboard.
They did everything.
Wow.
Come out, it came out, but it just wanted to.
So this is a case of, I know that I'm in the right, I know that I have nothing against me, I'm clean, so let me just look fresh, and then he just died. Like, it's...
Oh, that's so sad.
Yeah, so, so sad.
And it sparked the revolution in the movie. They, they change, man. Crazy,
wow.
Man.
Crazy, crazy, crazy stuff right there on police brutality. The second movie on our list is called Monsters and Men. Police brutality and racial profiling are two of the heavily featured themes in this 2018 movie. The movie tells the story of three intertwined characters, Manny, Dennis, and Zidric. On that fateful day, Manny goes out to hang out with some of his friends when a cop car drives by. In an incident very, very similar to George Floyd's death, six police officers attempt to arrest a friend of Manny's who sells cigarettes on the streets. When the situation becomes heated, a cop fires his gun and kills Darius while Manny is recording the entire incident from his phone. When Manny releases the clip, all hell is let loose. Cast members include Rob Morgan, John David Washington, Kelvin Harrison Jr., and others. Check it out.
About it. They're going to make an example out of you.
What should I do?
The twist in this movie is quite serious, just because, I mean, in the real George Floyd situation, we're not so sure the race. I think it was a black person that recorded this. But in this case, this is somebody that is, I think, Latino or some other race. And now the pressure is on him. Oh, don't let the cat out of the bag. We're going to make an example out of you. You're going to be terrorized for putting out this tape, which he eventually did. Very, very similar to George Floyd. And again, it just begs the question, how long do we keep accepting the same nonsense for?
It's you don't crazy. Even want to know what this is doing to my mood already. All right, let's talk about When They See Us. The 2019 American crime drama miniseries is based on event of the 1989 Central Park jogger case and explores the lives and families of the five young black male suspects who were falsely accused and then prosecuted on charges related to the rape and assault of a white woman in Central Park, New York City. The story expresses how the cops charged to protect the public lied and twisted their tales to indict the boys. Cast members include Gerald Jerome, Ashanti Black, Jovan Adepo, Joshua Jackson, Vera Femingar, and Felicity of Man. The miniseries was directed by Academy Award nominee Ava DuVernay.
And they come in closer.
So
one thing I don't even understand about the police job or their job description is, do they learn this like lying against people and then twisting stories?
Manipulate, because
sometimes,
your brain.
Yes, sometimes, or can we even say gaslighting? Mm-hmm. Like, you're just manipulating mm-hmm. stuff right there, mm-hmm. and then you're making people say what they did not do. Yeah. Like, is it part of it? So if you're not a criminal because they have put so much fear in you, you don't have to
say it.
I think this is just so pathetic.
It's a true life story.
I think that is one of the reasons why this particular miniseries is very painful, just because it actually happened mm-hmm. in real life. And these are people who had to do the time, had to mm-hmm. spend between 10 to 15 years in jail for something that they didn't do. To answer your question, I'm not sure that is a formal training that they get, obviously. However, it's almost, I don't know whether I should call it negligence or, you know, wanting to take the easy road out, because somebody dies and somebody demands an answer and you don't have enough, you don't want to research enough, or you don't want to investigate it enough. And you, again, there's an issue of profiling, which also happened in this series. Movie, yeah. There were four, five black boys walking around. Of course they
aimlessly.
Did it, because they were black. You don't even want to think that there could be another alternative. So there was a lot of the storytelling focused on racism that was happening mm-hmm. in America at the time, and focused on how profiling, manipulation, gaslighting, and also trying to cover face mm-hmm. because the public was needed demanding an answer.
And I do understand, and I know for a fact, perhaps, that police, when they really want to do their job,
they go in.
They really go in mm-hmm. because they have that training. But is it that somehow they're just lazy?
It's very, very deep.
Yes, number four on our list, Fruitvale Station. Yes, Fruitvale Station is one of the most heartbreaking movies about police brutality. The story unfolds into the life and times of the main character, Oscar, a black man who is murdered by police on a whim. The film details everything that led up to the fateful moment when Officer Caruso, played by Kevin Durant, decided to murder Oscar. Cast members include Michael B. Jordan, Melanie Diaz, and Octavia Spencer, amongst others.
I'm good. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Oscar from Pharmacia?
Another sad story of police brutality and racism right there. All right, the fifth movie on our list is called Blindspotting. Now, Blindspotting is a 2018 comedy-drama film starring David Diggs and Rafael Casas. The plot starts off on a light note and slowly thickens as the friendship of two friends gets tested when Colin sees a police officer shoot a suspect in the back during a chase through the streets. The movie is not only interesting, it also gives an insight into the serious subject of police violence in the country.
You know, you don't have to act ghetto to hang out here. Can
you hear me now? You need to get rid of Miles.
Miles, this is my best friend.
He's gonna push
you. Yeah. Crazy, this one is on a lighter note. Yeah. I mean, it starts off showing of the dynamics of their friendship. But however, there are very serious undertones there, mm-hmm. talking about how, you know, his white friend, you could come, go around with a gun and nothing was, it was something that, it was not a big deal. And then I can get a gun, why not? And he's like terrified, like, please, oh, I have 3 days left on my parole. And then the fact that he had to witness that and he has to make a decision, okay, am I going to go back and say this is what I saw? Or am I going to continue living my life? And this is something that we all face, you know, in the day to day. What are you going to do?
Yeah, look at the part where the young girl just said, don't shoot. Like, we are trained to that point whereby, see, my hand is on the dashboard, please.
Yeah. Yeah, it's crazy.
Crazy.
I mean,
man.
That is racism going on there, where, you know, we know that that's whites against blacks. But it's also very terrifying when, even back to our own country, mm-hmm. we're seeing these kind of things happening. Black against black, our people against our people. It's very sad.
Because you're
and
looking
it's very
fly.
Good that we're coming out to speak up about it.
You're looking fly, you drive nice car.
Yes.
What's the worth of a human life?
Yeah.
That is on today's Daily 2-5. We'll be back after this break for What Are You Watching? Yes, you should know that it is Tuesday on this show because it comes with a peculiar style to it. All right, What Are You Watching is back again. As usual, we will be sharing and talking about some of the movies and shows we recently watched. And we will also love to hear from you as well as you tell us about yours later on. Okay, so Twitter us at TVC Connect with the hashtag Splash on TVC. Okay, so who starts?
Okay, let me go. I watch Enola Holmes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Elena Holmes, actors in this movie, Bobby, Ethan, even found out other things about her mother's disappearance. What made the movie, the film interesting for me is the fact whereby the mystery that surrounds Sherlock Holmes and his family.
Yeah.
So this is Sherlock Holmes' sister now.
Oh, wow.
She also has that talent of unraveling things. So that one made it interesting for me.
This is a new movie.
Yeah, and she did. Like, there are puzzles everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
You just look at this thing and say, oh, so for my mother to have dropped this thing like this,
that's a that clue.
Means this is a clue. That means she left this. She didn't leave. She wasn't kidnapped, because if she was kidnapped,
trying to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If she was Enola Holmes, because it's a Sherlock Holmes series, it's from the Sherlock Holmes family. And of course, I love the mystery about Sherlock Holmes. I'll give it 8/10. 8/10.
And that's
I would
a
like
good
to
score.
Say it. Yes,
yeah.
I would like to say
especially
it.
Because the spin-off of Sherlock Holmes right there. And it's so interesting to see, as you said, that if his sister also has that skill.
He was shocked.
And he's almost like, are you trying to take my job? You know, were they together on it?
Yeah.
He and his sister were helping
each
other out.
It was later on, he was trying to unravel the secret, then sister too was doing the horn.
Wow.
She left the house. The brother now traced where the sister was, using his whole intelligence and everything. Okay, since you're doing this.
We'll see the Holmes family.
They should just do it at me. Amazing movie, by the way. Enola Holmes.
All right. 8/10. That's a very good score coming from you. Okay, so what did I watch? I watched something that can be classified as something like drama, horror, fantasy, along that line. It's a thriller. It's called Haunting of Bly Manor. Now, some of the actors in the film, we have Victoria Pedretti, we have Olivia Jackson, we have Amelia Eve, we have so many people. Fantastic actors and actresses in this one. I would commend the child actors right there that played it. I think they did a fantastic job. So this series, actually not a movie, is about this house, this manor, somewhere in England, and how it has this ghost story around it. So it started off with someone explaining the history of the manor and I can't explain the whole series, but basically it centers around an au pair who is like a nanny who goes to take care of these kids. Now, nobody has wanted to take care of these kids for the past 6 months. She has been seeing this notice and she's wondering why the pay is good. You're living in a mansion. Why doesn't anybody want it? You know how they say, oh, when something looks too good, like, run away. So she took the job and then she was trying to school these kids. And the kids are a little bit weird talking to people. Like, she's talking to them, but they are looking past her. Referring to her, telling her...
Like their house is haunted or something?
Don't sleep. Don't come out of your bed when you're sleeping. Don't do this. They're giving her rules. And she's like trying to fight back. All for her to find out that...
like tales?
There's a lot of history around the house. There's, in fact, a lot of ghosts in this house.
Yeah, haunted.
And there's a particular one that lives in the lake. I'm not going to spoil this for you guys. But the
I think the one in the lake would be the very difficult one.
Yeah, as if you know. Because for you to come out of water, So the particular scene that stuck out for me was actually finding out, which is a bit of a spoiler, actually finding out the history of the manor and why it was haunted. And it came about because somebody who used to live there in the 17th century was going to die. And when they were trying to perform her death rites, they brought a priest and they were like, okay, say these things. But she was sort of like a feminist back then. She was the kind of person that when she was getting married, she did not say to love and to obey. She said to love. She remove, obey. So they were trying to tell her, do this, you know, so that you can be appeased or whatever. That was how it was done back then. She said, no, tell your God that I do not go.
Wow.
And this scene really stuck out for me because true, as she died, she did not go.
Are you serious?
She stayed there. Her spirit did not roam. Her spirit did not ascend.
Because she's not happened. Even signed to obey.
What happened was she created her own gravity.
Wow.
Where this is her world and this is
Ojuju,
what
Ojuju straight up, man.
On another level, Ojuju upgraded.
I was able to sleep.
In fact, yesterday, I called and asked my parents up and down and said, can people reject to die? Is it how, is it possible?
Wow.
Can you just say?
Yourself? You see yourself so, being affected.
So I'll rate it out of 10. I'm going to rate it... A strong 8/10.
This is
yes.
A series.
This is a series. I finished watching it, by the way. Yesterday when I was stuck in traffic, that's what I was doing with my life. I finished watching it. I'll rate it an 8 just because of the way they took us up and down. There were a lot of stories that didn't really connect until the very end. I wish it was more
connected,
focused.
Not like Tenet.
It did. Ah, on Mother Tenet. Is that what you watched this weekend?
And I have to tell everybody that you got to the cinema, you sat down and you broke the chair.
I heard. On National TV, you just chose to just disgrace me like that.
What
as you are looking at me, does it look like something I can do? Ah! Me. Just sit down.
They do not
peacefully.
Know. They don't know.
Don't
let me talk about that Yoruba side of you. Let's just face it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, please focus.
Yeah.
Because this girl.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
All right.
So what did you watch?
I have been watching a docu-series. Mm-hmm. And it is called Journey of an African Colony.
Hmm.
Yes. It talks about Nigeria. So you want to know the people in it. It's a docuseries. So it happened at a race course then, now Tafalba Lewa Square, you know. They talked about how the British flag was coming down and then,
the
Nigerian flag was going up and they were just so happy, you know, the happiness in them and all that. And, it talks about, how Great Britain actually gave the reign of power to Nigeria. So it started that way. He talks about, so the narrator is a historian. Yes, I should add that to read, and a writer. So it was well told. I got so many information. It is not something you want to watch in a hurry or where they're talking. You just want to pay attention so that you can actually take some stock of some things about your country, Nigeria, about, being an African in general. And, I got to know that there is, there are traces of Igbo language in Barbados. Yes, traces of Igbo names and language, in Barbados. And there are traces of Yoruba names and language in, Brazil too.
Yeah,
it talks about so many things. I mean, this is a must watch. It tells us about how the freedom fighters were fighting for independence. And somehow, you look at what is happening at the moment, people protesting and fighting for their rights, and you want to liken it a bit. It's so in-depth. You want to know more about Nigeria, I think you should see this. So I've told you what stood out for me right there. Now let's talk about my rating. I'll rate it 9.7 over 10.
It's a docu series.
This deserves a slow clap. Honeypot.
That research was tight. That
love
went everywhere, to Benin, to the UK, to Brazil, to Cuba, to everywhere. Anything is talking
about.
What's the title again?
Journey of an African Colony.
I mean, 9.7 comes from Honeypot. I'm going to watch it.
Yeah.
And as you said, it's very important to know the history of where you're coming from and what your story really is.
Yes,
wow,
sir.
Fantastic.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll take a break now. And when we come back, it'll be time for you to share with us which Nigerian or foreign movies or shows did you recently watch? Tell us what's so special about it. Who acted in it? What scenes or scenes caught your fancy? And most importantly, how will you rate the movie? All of this after this break. Stay with us.
Yes, guys, we are back and we have told you what we are currently watching. It's time for you to tell us what you are currently watching. And of course, we have some messages on social media. As Angie NK says, hello, guys, you are all looking great. Thank you so much. I just finished watching Umbrella Academy season 1 and 2. I rated 8.5 over 10. I also watched Doom Patrol, The Orville and Mando Lareen.
Amanda's people.
Yes, Umbrella Academy. I've spoken about this a couple of times. Fantastic series.
I've not gone back to it.
Fantastic series. Go back to it. No, maybe if you like superhero films, you might like this one. If you don't, kind of like that.
Yeah. All right, Shirley Bright is here and said to watch Cursed. It's about fairy tales and magic. I rate it 8 over 10.
Okay.
Deborah 817 says, I'm currently watching Supergirl season 5. Love everything about the movie because an actress I love acted in it, and I'll rate it 8 over 10. Okay, Supergirl. It's all right.
Moving on to Facebook, Misoma. We have to first of all say thank you so much for always commenting.
Yes.
Ezeifuli. I'm sure I'm spoiling your name, but don't be upset, okay? It says, good day, people. I hope you all are safe, peaceful. Yes, we're trying to. I'm watching the Men's Club web series, waiting for the final episode of season 3, which is dropping tomorrow. Our rate is 7 over 10.
I watched a bit of it.
Men's Club.
I watched a bit of it.
Yeah.
And not bad.
Not bad at all.
And it's Nigerian, so.
Yes, it is. Probably Nigerian.
Okay, so we have Flawless Blaze, who says, I recently watched My Spy. It is a comedy action movie about a 9-year-old girl who catches a CIA agent spying on her family during a routine surveillance in a bid not to get his cover blown. He agrees to teach the girl how to become a spy. I'll rate it 8/10.
I've seen this one. Hello, good afternoon.
I'm fine.
So do you want to tell us about the movies you're currently watching or series that you've watched?
Yes.
So feel free. Let's go. Okay. Elizabeth, feel free to call us back. We'll continue with the Facebook messages. This one is from T. Wilson and says, I recently watched Oluture. I rated 70%. Happy belated birthday, OJ. I didn't get to wish you then. Thank you very much. Yeah, Oluture, amazing movie.
Yeah. And it's only this person that went 70%. We said over 10.
So
it's good. We like 7/10. 10, of course, of course.
And the writer or the producer of the movie said, because of the way it ended, I heard they said there's no, like, a sequel.
No, there should be a sequel.
He said that.
So that's how the reporter went to.
He said that's how it is in real life, that they just go and we don't hear from them.
Well, we'll keep our fingers crossed. Because, you know, Nigerians can shock you. They might not just want to, like, okay,
give it out
and
yet.
Then later they would.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Because I know that it's somebody's story, actually.
Okay.
All right. Sisi Wumi says, Fate of Alakada. From Sisi Wumi, go, what you would have done? I'm sorry. I'm just joking, Sisi Wumi. Fate of Alakada, the party planner. In fact, I'll rate it 100%. Sisi Wumi. You know, I can be messy sometimes.
Everybody's in that movie, by the way.
Yes,
everybody's
of course.
Of Alakada.
Because we too, Gongwapa, after watching Tenet, we said maybe we should have watched Alakada Reloaded. Or what do you think? Okay. Amanda does not want to talk about it. I looked dumb after that. All right, up next is Where Are They Now? Take a look to find out which actor we're talking about today.
Where Are They Now? Chiego Alesigwe. When we hear this name, only one thing reverberates in our ears. Outstanding. This beautiful actress earned the love of many viewers with her seamless interpretation of her roles. Chiego began acting small roles before she had a breakthrough movie, My Love, featuring Ramsey Noah in 1998. And ever since, her success in the industry has been phenomenal. Chiego was one of the top actresses in the Nollywood industry, and in 2002, she got married and divorced in just 3 months.
This thing hasn't happened to me before, but I just saw you and I knew I needed to know you.
At this time, her presence in the industry began to dwindle. And after a while, she permanently left the industry to focus on her NGO project to cater for the less privileged and disabled persons as well as disease awareness among the masses.
I just finished discussing with the manager. These are some business proposals.
Now you know where they are now.
Yes. Now you know where they are now.
Super talented actress. Ladies and gentlemen, we gotta go. Our time right here is done and dusted right here on the show. Thank you to you and you and you for participating and reaching out to us on Twitter, Facebook, and of course via phone call. We gotta go.